Caitlin, I am not a perfect person. I have flaws and gaps in my character, but I also have you. You fill those gaps better than anyone I have ever met. Time and again over the last 3 years, when one of us discovers a weakness, the other discovers a strength. I know that if we stay true to each other, those gifts will translate into a successful marriage, a blessed parenthood, and a continued relationship built on trust and respect. I promise you that for the rest of my life, I will continue to love and respect you, to maintain my devotion and fidelity to you, and to support you in our shared life. For richer or poorer, in sickness and in health, I promise to be your partner until death parts us.
Justin, I am so excited to enter this next chapter together. Saying yes as you were on one knee was the easiest decision I've ever had to make. I love the way you love, care about me. I love the way you love, care about, and support me every day. Today, I promise, in front of our family and friends, I will always choose you. I choose you to be my travel buddy, my best friend, and my life partner. I choose you to be my forever sushi date. I choose to grow old with you, to learn from you and with you. I promise to support you always, laugh with you in the good times, and be there in the hard times. I promise to encourage you and respect you. I promise to be your biggest cheerleader. I look forward to starting a family and experiencing life together. Justin, I love you with all of my heart.
This ring I give you.
This ring I give you.
As a symbol of my enduring love and devotion.
As a symbol of my enduring love and devotion.
With this ring I thee wed.
With this ring I thee wed.
Just as this ring has no end.
Just as this ring has no end.
So also may our love be without end.
So also may our love be without end.
This pledge I gladly make.
This pledge I gladly make.
In the presence of these witnesses.
In the presence of these witnesses.
And before Almighty God.
And before Almighty God.
This ring I give you.
This ring I give you.
As a symbol of my enduring love and devotion.
As a symbol of my enduring love and devotion.
With this ring I thee wed.
With this ring I thee wed.
Just as this ring has no end.
Just as this ring has no end.
So also may our love be without end.
So also may our love be without end.
This pledge I gladly make.
This pledge I gladly make.
In the presence of these witnesses.
In the presence of these witnesses.
And before Almighty God.
And before Almighty God.
At this time, Justin, you may kiss your bride.
reach us.
Butterfly kisses.
Thank you. Yes. And ladies and gentlemen, a round of applause to the Queen's Street Theater.
So Caitlin was the first friend that I made at Penn State. It happened the summer before our freshman year. I can't believe how fast the time flies, but I will say your friendship and my love for you, it grows stronger every year. I'm so honored to be here by your side, and I'm incredibly happy for you.
I'm going to try my hardest.
Okay, so anyone who knows Caitlin knows her bubbly personality and positive attitude are absolutely infectious. So you can spend 5 minutes with this girl, and you'll leave feeling like a million bucks. Because she does everything she can to ensure you are listened to, cared for, and cheered up. You just know that she'll always put 110% of herself into every relationship, and you'll never be taken for granted. I admire these qualities and so many more, and I think that's what drew me to you so quickly at Penn State. I knew instantly we'd be best friends. It of course helps that we're the same person. You knew I was gonna make that.
So
for everyone else, we have this joke about how similar we are, because we think the same way. We have literally finished each other's sentences. We're extremely outgoing, and we just enjoy the same hobbies. Being competitive, and beating Justin and Travis, and beer pong, repeatedly, because losing once wasn't enough for them. So it turned into the best of three, and then the best out of five, and then seven, until eventually you just had to cut it off. It got pretty embarrassing. These similarities continued recently with the timing of our engagements. They were only 2 weeks apart, and our wedding, which was 2 months apart. It's been a blast to have gone through this exciting time in our lives together, and there's absolutely no one I'd rather do it with. You could definitely say that I was looking forward to her wedding way more than my own. That would be because I didn't have to plan it, so that was good. But it's also because I love both of these people so much, and I have never been so excited about two people coming together as one. Justin, you've been a constant since Penn State as well, and I couldn't have chosen a better guy for my best friend. You are someone I've always looked up to and respected so much, and I believe the two of you work so well together. I've always felt that open communication has been the key to successful relationships, and I can confidently say that the two of you have that down. I can't wait to see what the future holds, as long as that means you're not going to move off to North Carolina. Please don't leave me. I have high hopes, though, that our children will grow up together, and we'll be very close for the long run. So I love you guys so much. Thank you again for your unwavering support, and I wish you both the absolute best. To Caitlin and Justin.
It was something like, actually, it's your vows, where he's weak, she's strong, vice versa. That was Mariah and I for this whole process. I had a lot of weaknesses, and Mariah had a lot of strengths, and so I could relate. That's all I have to say. Now to actually start my speech. Good evening, everyone. For those of you who are wondering who this wild woman is, my name is Carolyn, and I've had the absolute honor of being Caitlin's best friend since our freshman year at Penn State when we were randomly assigned roommates. I remember I moved my stuff into our dorm room and promptly ran off somewhere where I wasn't buying books, or signing up for classes, or doing really anything at all to prepare for college. I remember being so nervous to meet Caitlin because I had heard horror stories about random roommates. When I got back to the dorm and finally got to talk to her, I remember being put at ease instantly. At the time, neither one of us drank. Things have changed. We both really love to meet new people. And we weren't interested in staying in our dorm room very often. Even though our friendship developed very quickly, we had our awkward moments as all strangers do. There was a time a cicada rolled into my leggings, and somehow Caitlin had to help me pull it out, and it then moved down the hallway, and we were terrified of it for like a week. We checked under everything. Yeah, we put like a plastic bowl on it, and it was in the hallway, and it was like, we kept checking on it. There's also the time that we both brushed our teeth for way too long in the mirror together. This is the first time we had brushed our teeth together. We were afraid that the other one would judge us for not brushing our teeth, but the dentist recommended 2 full minutes. There was another time when Caitlin got locked out of our apartment dorm at 3 in the morning, and she had to call me and text me, and she was so shy about it, but she was with a guy, and I had to go let her in. She felt bad. But in the time, there's also the time when Caitlin was asleep in her bed and stared at me in silence for an uncomfortable amount of time as I did my morning routine. I thought that she was sleeping with her eyes open, and then she gave me this like tiny, creepiest wave I've ever seen. She was like, turns out she'd been watching me. Caitlin and I spend a ton of time together, and I admired a lot about her. Her dedication to school, her desire to help others, and her ability to balance family, friends, and work, especially classwork, something that I struggled with tremendously. But the thing I admire most about Caitlin is her fearless spirit and extreme confidence in social settings. I'll never forget the time that Caitlin was asked to rap on stage with a local cover band, Go Go Gadget. When she got on stage and started rapping, I was thinking one thing and one thing only. I would never, ever, ever do something like this in 9 million years. Unless, of course, my best friend were getting married and asked me to prepare a speech for her wedding. So, Taz the DJ, unfortunately, it's about that time. Wait! Hold on! Not yet! Sorry. I want to also invite... I learned a lot about myself being a maid of honor. I'm a lyrical genius. However, singing is really hard. So I would like to invite our matron of honor, Mariah Buffington, to sing with me. I have prepared a rap for all of you tonight.
Yeah. me. My name's Matt Sargero. One of the best men.
Woo!
I know Justin since third grade. St. Catherine's Library together. We got to know each other over the next couple years. We became really good friends. Being such close friends, I was able to grow up feeling like a part of the Campbell family. What I think of a friendship, I think of someone who cares for you and helps you grow and become a better person. That's how I see my friendship with Justin. I have a quiet, introverted personality. I'm not comfortable seeking out new experiences. My friendship with Justin helped me to grow in this area. He shared his appreciation for music by inviting me to concerts and included me with his friends when they made plans. The way Justin and I supported and helped each other as friends is what I have watched. It's what I have watched them grow. I've supported and helped each other as friends is what I've watched grow over the years in the strong couple that Caitlin and Justin have become. Two different people living separate lives have come together as one to plan their future. I have watched Justin transition from making decisions alone to making decisions with Caitlin. Except for the wedding decisions, of course. They're all me. It's my privilege to be their friend. It's an honor to be part of this special day. I look forward to sharing in their future as they begin their married life. To Justin and Caitlin, all the best, and may God continue to bless you.
So I went back to my roots in school, and I went right to the internet. After a few hours of spending time on the internet, I found a lot of really good stuff. Like, have you seen all the videos of the kids eating Tide Pods? All over. After I collected myself and reminded myself what I was looking for on the internet, I found a couple of articles that recommended at this point in the speech I tell a couple of embarrassing stories. But I didn't think that was right. I don't think I should be standing up here in front of everybody and telling them about all the stupid stuff we've done. Right? So I'm not going to tell them about the time that we were in Arizona. And you got lost 4 consecutive days on a traffic circle on the resort complex. I'll leave that one out. And I've already scratched out the part when we were in Yellowstone and I was waiting for you to come out of the bathroom. Yeah, you had a look of horror on your face, just like this one. Until I found out what was going on. So apparently the lack of urinals in the bathroom wasn't enough. It took until Justin was washing his hands next to a lady to realize the mistake he had made. I don't want to tell embarrassing stories like that, so I'm going to talk about some of the good stuff that we've done for him. We've had 30 years together, man, and we've had a hell of a ride so far. So, 2 weeks after I was born, I was blessed with a cousin who might as well be my brother. My stepbrother. Sorry, that's an inside joke. We must have really parted those first few years because I remember less about those than the 3 years we lived together in college. But in our younger years, those are some of my fondest memories. I mean, whether it was playing with Legos on Grandma and Grandpa's pool table, I'm sure she loved that. Or trying to survive a shark attack in our cousin Mike's pool from the Polaris. Or definitely running away from your dad, my Uncle Jerry, as he was pretending to be a grizzly bear, running us down throughout the house. But far and away, my most memorable moment of that time of our lives was the 4 years that we spent absolutely nothing, or absolutely all of our time doing nothing, but going to school and playing Soka. There's a lot of people that play that video game with us in here. Certainly changed our lives. Like, seriously, at least a year of actual hours playing this video game. A few times so far in our lives, we've been pretty close to greatness, but I think we've come up short. We just missed the mark. When we were playing SOCOM, we were among the best, right? But that was before streaming games became popular. Now there's someone that's making $500,000 a month playing video games.
Yeah, that's true.
Thanks for telling me to put the games down, Mom. Another time in college, we developed a media server where we would stream movies and TV shows directly to our TV. This was basically out of curiosity and laziness because we didn't want to get up and put the DVD in the DVD player. But we never thought it was a business idea. A year later, you know, a company you guys may have heard about, Netflix, they started introducing this service widespread. Instead of a multi-billion dollar company, we got kicked off of Comcast. Yeah, Comcast told us, no, we don't want your business.
Wow.
But I do have some good news. I think you finally hit your stride. You found greatness in your relationship with Caitlin. I think that marrying such a fantastic girl is probably your best idea to date. Money will come and go, but love like this will last a lifetime.
Absolutely.
So I want to wish you a very strong and happy marriage, and everyone please raise your glass to the bride and groom.
Well, as Caitlin is making her way down, very well done, my man. Let's give our group a round of applause. And show us what your mama gave you. Yeah. so little birthday. Everybody, the party's not over. There is an after party at the Osteria Bar.